Mother Yashoda wondered. She was always thinking why her son was stealing makhan or butter. Because she always used to hear from so many different gopis that their son, Krishna, Yashoda's and Nandbaba's son Krishna, used to often come and steal butter from their house. Now in Mother Yashoda's house, there were many maid servants who milked the cows and made yogurt and made butter and did various other household duties. Now Nanda Maharaj had 9 lakh cows, and most of these cows produced milk which were converted into yogurt and makhan, butter. So there was lot of milk, there was lot of yogurt, there was lot of butter. So there was no need for Krishna to go out and steal. Now when so many maid servants were engaged in taking out lot of butter and yogurt, and still if your son is going out for stealing, then Mother Yashoda was saying, what is wrong? Mother Yashoda, she thought to herself that that certainly there has to be some sense with so many gopis are often complaining that Krishna is going to their houses and stealing the butter. So because of this, she had doubts about her process of making the butter. And she thought that maybe that my yogurt, my butter is not coming out so good. So let me, because why is the reason? She was thinking that maybe that the maid servants are making and the maid servants are not making out of love. So much love which I have for Krishna. So let me try to make the butter myself. Otherwise, she was thinking that there has to be no reason that Krishna has to go out and steal somebody. Imagine a person whose son or daughter is very wealthy, absolutely very wealthy, filthy wealthy, lot of wealth is there, but still their son or daughter, they go out and steal at somebody else's houses. So what can be the reason? So she did not, Mother Yashoda did not realize that Krishna went to the house of other gopis out of love and not for simply stealing the butter. So Mother Yashoda did not realize this, and she had this doubt that might be there her own butter, or in her own house the butter which is made is not proper. So she decided, the queen of Braja, Mother Yashoda, she decided that she will churn the butter herself. For what reason? To satisfy Krishna. Now here there is a word, ekada grahi daseshu. Now in the Sanskrit, da, ekada, da means time. It is, this da word is used in various words like sarvada, ekada, yada, kada. Ekada means at one time, yada means at some time, kada means at which time, and sarvada means at all time. So here Shukadev Goswami is saying ekada grahida seshu. Ekada means, Mother Yashoda is saying that Mother Yashoda started to churn the yogurt. And when did, so what did this other maid servants who were engaged in that say, what did they do? Karamantara niyuktashu. She engaged them in other services. In some of the acharyas, they say that at the same time, the Govardhan Puja celebration was also going on. So Mother Yashoda, Indra Puja celebration was going. Indra Puja was an activity which was performed every year. So Mother Yashoda engaged other gopis in the Indra Puja, Indra Yajna. And so she started herself churning the butter. Now, Ekada here refers to the day of Deepavali in the month of Kartik. Now this was the day Mother Yashoda bound Krishna. Many of Krishna's prominent leelas, actually they occurred in the Sharad Kala or Kartika. Some examples are Rasa Leela, Govardhan Leela, Damodar Leela. So all these leelas that took in Kartik month. So Kartik month is very, very auspicious, and we should take shelter of this Krishna's divine pastimes which are mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, by hearing them, by reading them and speaking about them. And thus we shall absorb ourselves in Krishna Lila in this whole of Kartik month. So to stop Krishna from stealing and to keep him happy at home, Mother Yashoda started to churn yogurt. And while doing so, what did she do? She sang the glories of Lord Krishna's childhood pastime. Yani yaniha gitani tad bala charitani cha. So Mother Yashoda sang about which lilas which Krishna has performed, like the deliverance of Putra, deliverance of Aghasura, deliverance of Shaktasura, Tranavat, and Krishna's lila of learning to walk, Krishna's lila of eating butter, and other lilas which he has performed. So Mother Yashoda sang spontaneously as this memories arose in her heart. Now, as she remembered this wonderful pastime, she was naturally very joyful. If we can relate to this, that if we are absorbed in thinking of Krishna or singing about his glories or his sitting in a class, then we are very peaceful, we are very joyful, we are very happy. And so when was she singing this? When was she singing? Dadhi Nirmam Tane Kale. Mother Yashoda was singing this Krishna's pastime at the time of churning the yogurt. Now, Shukadeva Goswami, he describes this wonderful picture. What is he saying? Shukadeva Goswami is saying that he says, Kshomam Vashaha Pratukate Bibrati. Kshomam means saffron yellow color. Now, Mother Yashoda was wearing a saffron yellow sari. And Sutranadham, it was tied tightly on her hips with a belt. Now, dressed in this way, Mother Yashoda was fully prepared to do this seva. Now, this was this particular pastimes which Mother Yashoda was doing of churning the butter was early in the morning at the time of Brahma Bhurta. At that time, Krishna was sleeping, and Mother Yashoda woke up early that day and she started to churn the butter. Now, Mother Yashoda was doing this service. Now, one might question that why was she wearing a saffron yellow color sari? It is said that saffron is a very pure color, so by wearing that, she could perform her seva very nicely, perfectly. Now, putra sneha sutta putra yugam tatak. Now, Mother Yashoda's breasts were moving from because of the motion of the churning rod, and because of her unalloyed love, putra sneha, because of unalloyed love for her son, naturally the milk was coming from her breast. Now, why was milk coming from her breast? One of the acharyas have asked. It is said that in the acharyas have written that it is said that in the transcendental world, everything is conscious. So this is just the opposite of the material world, where almost everything is like dead material. So Mother Yashoda's milk, because of being a transcendental nature, was thinking that today Mother Yashoda is working hard to extract the butter and which will be fed to Krishna. Now, therefore, he will eat the butter and will become satisfied. So he will not drink me. So being deprived of Krishna's service, what will happen to me? So thinking in this way, the milk was flowing out from her breast. Now, Mother Yashoda was churning the yogurt, and as she was pulling the rope of the churning rod, her golden bangles, she was wearing a golden bangles, they were shaking and they were making a very sweet sound. Jan, jan, jan. And her earrings, she had earrings and that shook and jingled harmoniously. Her ankle bells and the golden belt where she was wearing around her waist also joined in. And in this way, Mother Yashoda, although she was singing this glorious pastimes of the Lord and all these other different ornaments on her body acted like an different musical instruments. So she was churning the yogurt. Gharad, gharad, gharad. Sound was coming from as if like an expert mridanga player was playing. So Mother Yashoda had full musical accompaniment, and she continued to sing this Krishna's glorious past, childhood pastime. So she became so absorbed in this churning that she completely forgot herself and lost awareness of her own body. So she was, now when someone works hard and perspires, his beauty and charm increases, especially when engaged in performing devotional service. Now, she was wearing a garland of multi flowers. Even the multi flowers were falling from her garland due to her intense endeavors. So, in this way, her entire body was engaged in intensive labor, parishrama, to make butter for Krishna. Her tongue was singing the glories and pastimes of the Lord, her ears were engaged in hearing those songs, and her mind was remembering and meditating on how she could make the butter to feed Krishna. Now, this is a perfect state of a devotee, fully engaging mind, body, and intelligence in service of Krishna. Now, many acharyas, they have given the realization on these pastimes. Why were bangles making a sound? Jan, jan, jan. In the transcendental world, even the bangles are conscious. So the bangles are thinking that today we are so fortunate to be on the hands of Mother Yashoda, who are engaged in Krishna Seva. So they were singing out of joy and congratulating her. So this is the mood different acharyas have expressed in their writings. In reality, our hands do not become beautiful simply by wearing golden jewelry. Our hands can only be considered beautiful if we engage them in the service of the Supreme Lord. And her earrings were also moving back and forth as if jumping out of joy. So what they were thinking, so our acharyas are writing that today we are fortunate to be on the ears that are engaged in hearing the glories of Krishna. So this was her mood. What were the multi flowers? What was the mood of the multi flowers? The multi flowers were thinking that it was today Mother Yashoda is engaged in Krishna's service, and hence we do not belong to her head, but we should be in her feet instead. That's why the multi flowers were falling from her head, and they're falling exactly at her lotus feet. So Mother Yashoda, in this way, she was very joyfully and fully absorbed in this Dadi Manthana Seva, the turning of the yogurt into butter. So hearing Mother Yashoda's voice and melodious sound of Dadi Manthan, what happened? Krishna woke up earlier than usual. Now, on this day, today, Deva Deepavali, where Mother Yashoda was churning the butter for Krishna, Krishna woke up. And when Krishna started looking on the bed itself, she started looking, where is my ma? Where is my mother? And then Krishna couldn't find her on the bed. So when he heard her singing in another room, he immediately thought, what is wrong with her today? She's not worried for me at all. She treats me like an, she giving up my service, she is doing this ordinary household duties. Now, Krishna woke up and he began to desire to drink her breast milk, Tanyakama. Now, children, even when they are babies, are very expert at getting the attention they want. When they don't get the attention they seek, they become very naughty. Usually, when Krishna wakes up, Mother Yashoda is right there near to him. She hugs him, feeds him, pampers him. So she does everything to love him. As soon as he gets up, Mother Yashoda is always there for Krishna. But today it was different. Mother Yashoda was completely ignoring him. Krishna thought, is this housework so important? She has to leave me. So Krishna started crying. And then he walked to where the churning of the yogurt, Dadi Manthanam, was happening. And Mother Yashoda, she did not notice. She did not notice that Krishna had come. Now, there is an important lesson here. Very important lesson. when will Krishna come to us? Krishna will not come to us when we are simply relaxing comfortably and thinking ourselves to be absorbed in meditation on Him. However, if He feels greatly obliged to come to us when we are absorbed in devotional service, working hard and even perspiring for Him. So Krishna feels compelled to give us His darshan when we are so completely engaged in devotional service that we may not even notice His very presence. Now this baby Krishna was looking around and he wondered what he could do to get the attention of his mother. So Krishna, he caught hold of that churning rod and he hurled it firmly with both hands as if applying the brake to a fast moving bicycle. In this way, he indicated to Mother Yashoda, "Stop, I need your attention, feed me now." So one of the acharyas has given the realization as why Krishna stopped the churning. We need to understand why is this acharyas are comparing this churning to something. Now all the gyanis are constantly reading and analyzing the scriptures, trying to extract the essence, just churning. At last, after so much churning for so many long years, at last they may approach Krishna. So Krishna is thinking this, for it is me who is to be known from all the scriptures. Oh my dear mother, you already have me. So what is the use of, why are you churning? So we can analyze the Upanishads, Vedas, the Puranas and other scriptures, but what is their final conclusion? All the scriptures, they conclude that attaining Krishna is the highest goal of life. That Krishna is the son of Madhurya Yashoda. So Krishna was thinking, why has my mother has to do this churning? Why was she doing this unnecessary labor? That's why Krishna stopped his mother from churning the yogurt. So Mother Yashoda, she looked at Krishna, but she did not pick him up. Now she wanted to see, Mother Yashoda wanted to see what Krishna will do. So Krishna, he caught hold of her arm with his both hands and put one foot on the rim of the yogurt pot and he climbed onto her lap and then he started drinking Mother Yashoda's breast milk. The Mother Yashoda was very amazed at her son's cleverness in getting what he wanted all by himself. She was amazed and she was full of motherly pride that see how her little son Krishna had done all these things. Now, upon realizing Krishna's desire, Mother Yashoda put aside all other work. Now she focused completely on feeding her charming little child. Krishna smiled, which made Mother Yashoda very, very happy. And while she was very proudly and pleasurably fed her son, Krishna and Mother Yashoda, they had a competition between them. Krishna wanted to give pleasure to, Mother Yashoda wanted to give pleasure to Krishna by feeding milk, and Krishna was also enjoying the milk, and by this he wanted to give pleasure to Mother Yashoda. Krishna, he thought to himself, how smart I am, I stopped mother from her work and now claim my right. Thinking in this way, he smiled continuously, making his chubby cheeks more adorable. So now, as Krishna was drinking Mother Yashoda's milk, there was a milk which was kept on the gas stove. And that milk, being of transcendental nature, it started thinking. The milk, Mother Yashoda was so absorbed in this baby Krishna, but she forgot completely about that milk. Now that milk was thinking that today Mother Yashoda is going to satisfy Krishna with her breast milk itself, and I will be useless. There was a milk which was kept in the pot, and it was thinking that I'll be useless. So let me commit suicide. Let me jump into the fire. If I cannot serve Krishna, then what is the use of my living? So the milk was trying to boil over and jump into the fire. But it caught Mother Yashoda's attention, and Mother Yashoda began to think that this milk is a very special milk from Padmaganda cows, and I must quickly go and save this milk for Krishna. My milk is always there, but this milk which I am trying to make for Krishna is a very special milk from Padmaganda cows. Now in Vrindavan, in Brajmandal, Padmaganda cows are very, very special. Extraordinarily fragrant grasses are reserved especially for their grazing. And their body, the Padmaganda cows, their body emanates beautiful, very wonderful lotus scent. Now, and out of total 9 lakh cows, there were only 100 such cows, and they produced a very special milk. And Mother Yashoda had kept that milk reserved especially for Krishna. Now as she ran to save this special milk, Krishna got very upset. Krishna got very upset, and he started yelling and screaming and saying that this is an offense to me. This was a little child. Mother Yashoda reached the stove and put the milk aside. In the meantime, what was Krishna thinking? Sanjata Kopa. Little boy, Krishna became angry. He thought, how dare mother put me aside while I am drinking the milk? I'm still hungry. And I left everything. I left my Vaikuntha and I just came here to drink her milk. And she is completely ignoring me. I am the proprietor of all the material and the spiritual world, and she's ignoring me. So how dare she? I need to teach this mother a lesson. Now Krishna has become very upset. I will show her. She'll be sorry for this activity of hers. And mother and Krishna, Krishna, he looked around and he saw a large spice grinding stone. Now with this stone, he very cleverly struck the yogurt churning pot. And what happened? When it got struck, and it didn't make a big sound, but it was the cause for all the yogurt to spill all over the floor. Now, as Krishna hit the spot, he realized what he just did. That Mother Yashoda was churning the butter. And now I broke that pot. So Krishna began to think, now Mother Yashoda is going to get upset with me. So how shall I save this situation? Now Krishna was thinking, how shall I run away now? I have to run away. I cannot just stand here, because Mother Yashoda is going to come and beat me up. So what should I do now? So Krishna, he walked through the yogurt that was split. And when he was walking, it made a very sound, chup, 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 chup. Now our acharyas, while writing commentary on this particular incident, they say that supreme lord who in the form of Vamandev spanned the whole universe with just 3 steps, now was walking through the split yogurt. He walked so quietly, this Krishna walked so quietly that his mother could not be able to hear the sound of his steps. So Krishna did not think that perhaps we should go around the yogurt. Krishna just thought that right now I just have to escape from here. I just have to run. So Krishna, he thought, now what, where should I go? So he thought to himself, let me go to the storehouse where there is old butter being kept. Now I will go there and I will start eating that old butter, and I'll fall sick because it is an old. It was old makhan, yes, from yesterday. So I might fall sick, and then my mother will have to take me to the hospital. So then she'll realize that how important it is to take care of me. So in this way, this little boy was thinking. And what happened was that Krishna actually did not start eating himself. He just took the pot down, and as soon as he did that, so many monkeys, they came there. The monkeys appeared from nowhere, and the Krishna started feeding the butter to the monkeys. Krishna has to put them in their mouth. In this way, Krishna was feeding all the monkeys, and he was freely distributing food for life, freely distributing, and even throwing the butter in all the directions. Now, mother, after rescuing the milk from the store, Mother Yashoda returned, and he saw that the yogurt pot had been smashed to pieces. Now, she immediately understood who did this. It is Krishna. Now, Mother Yashoda, she looked at the footprints of Krishna. Where is that little boy gone? And she was not really angry about the breaking the pot, because she was very rich and they don't mind so many pots are there, and if one gets broken, it's not a big thing for Mother Yashoda. But from this incident, she smiled to herself and thought that, just see how clever my Krishna is. He broke this pot in such a way that I didn't hear a sound. Now this boy is very clear, very, very clever, and very, very cheeky. Therefore, Mother Yashoda decided, today I have to punish him, because he has broken a pot. Who knows what he might do tomorrow? So I must teach him a lesson. In this way, she followed his little footprints. She hid herself behind a wall and looked around to spy on Krishna. Now Shukadeva Goswami, he's saying that Mother Yashoda saw Krishna, that there was a grinding mortar upside down, and Krishna was sitting on that and distributing butter to the monkeys. Now Mother Yashoda, she saw this, and then she went and she tried to catch Krishna and to beat him. What was the reason? To beat him. Now, as soon as Mother Yashoda was trying to approach Krishna, and Krishna saw her coming carrying a stick in her hand. Now, Krishna was afraid to look on his mother's face, and seeing that stick in her hand, Krishna jumped down from the grinding mortar and he fled. And Krishna knows that I am very quick and she won't be able to catch me. In his heart, Krishna knew that he had been naughty, and he had done many things that he should not have done. He had broken Mother Yashoda's yogurt pot. He had fled. He has given the old makhan to the monkeys. Now, normally, grahasthas, they're very protective about their household paraphernalia, and they store foodstuffs in the fridge and different places. But this Krishna was very naughty, and he not only broke the pot, but he also fed the old stuff to the monkeys. Now, it takes a lot of time to make a butter. Now, all that, if it is fed to the monkeys, so Mother Krishna knew what he did. Now, Mother Yashoda, she did not want to let Krishna get away just like that, because she was very, she was understanding that might be that these gopis who are complaining, are there is some truth in their complaints, because this boy is a big rascal, and if he can do this in his own house, certainly he might be doing this in the houses of so many people, so many gopis. So this was the first time that this Lila had taken place, where this is the first time that it is that Krishna is at fault. And his devotee was apparently angry at him. Can you imagine this pastimes? Krishna is at fault and his devotee, Mother Yashoda, was angry at him. Now, the yogis whose mind have become purified by performing all type of austerities and who can travel at the speed of wind cannot catch Krishna. They are unable to do so in their minds, even after thousands of years of meditation. However, in this Lila, in this Damodar Lila, Mother Yashoda was running after that same unattainable Krishna, chasing him with a stick in his hand, in her hand. At first, Krishna ran from room to room. Then he left the house and he ran from streets. He ran on the streets of Gokul. Then Mother Yashoda, seeing this naughtiness of Krishna, she took a vow that today Krishna is not going to get away from me. Whatever happens, I will pursue him. I will catch him and I will tie him up. I'll beat him up. So all the Brajavasis now, Krishna came out from the house and started going to the house of the different devotees. So Mother Yashoda was also behind Krishna. Then he went to different streets of Gokul. And Mother Yashoda also was behind Krishna, in the different going behind Krishna with a stick. Now all the Brajavasis looked on in amazement and they thought that what is happening today? Usually there is so much affection between Krishna and Mother Yashoda. So what could have possibly happened that today Mother Yashoda is behind Krishna? Now Krishna was running in a zigzag manner. He was running in and he was running out. He was going to different places. And Mother Yashoda was following Krishna. And although Mother Yashoda was not accustomed to running like this, so she soon became very tired and perspiring. After a long chase, Mother Yashoda finally he caught Krishna. After a long chase. And he firmly grasped his, she grasped his right hand. And with his left hand, Krishna, Mother Yashoda caught Krishna's right hand with his left hand. What was Krishna doing? He was wiping his tears. And Mother Yashoda addressed him, Vanar Bandhu, friend of the monkeys. Are these monkeys your relatives? Why are you feeding them so freely? You not only broke the pot, but you're also feeding the butter to the monkeys. Today I have caught you red-handed. So I'm going to punish you today. So little Krishna was shaking in fear. He was crying and he was wiping his tears with his hands. And this particular incident, Krishna's wiping his tears, was so beautiful. Some of the acharyas, they said that Kunti Maharani, Kunti Mataji, Kunti was also in Vrindavan. And she was also witnessing these wonderful pastimes. And Krishna was saying, "Oh, my dear mother, please let me go. I promise I will never do this again. Please let me go." And when Mother Yashoda saw that Krishna had become very frightened, Krishna was frightened. It is not that he was pretending to be frightened. Krishna was afraid at that time that Mother Yashoda might beat him up with a stick. So when Mother Yashoda saw that Krishna was frightened, she kept the stick down. And then Krishna, he breathed a sigh of relief, thinking that perhaps the worst was over. So he thought, at least she won't hit me now with a stick. Now I will not get beaten up so badly. If she'll beat me, it will just be a slap, not with a stick. Now this pastime demonstrates the uniqueness of Krishna's Brajalila. In no other incarnation does the Supreme Lord await judgment from anyone. Here, Krishna is guiltily standing in front of his mother, his fate completely in her hands. Mother Yashoda now has full jurisdiction to decide whether to punish, bind, or release Krishna. This is the speciality of the parental affection, Vatsalya Bhav of Vrindavan. Where the knowledge of Krishna's godhood is completely covered. Shukdev Goswami is saying, Arbhaka Vatsala. Seeing the genuine fear in the eyes of Krishna, Mother Yashoda, put her stick down and contemplated on how else to discipline her mischievous son. And after discarding the stick, she decided to tie him up. What reason she gave to herself? Our acharya is right that Krishna may run away to the bank of Yamuna in an angry mood, and whenever he does that, it becomes very difficult for me to get him back. So many times that Krishna might get fed up and he runs away, and it takes hours for him to come back. And Mother Yashoda thought to herself that I don't know what Krishna is going to do now. If he goes away in this mood, it will be very difficult to find him. Or it might happen that he might get hurt. So let me tie him up for a while, and I can churn the butter very peacefully, and then I will make some. I'll pacify him. So what was Mother Yashoda's consciousness as she tied her son Krishna? Adat Virya Kovita. It is said that due to intense love for Krishna, Mother Yashoda was not aware of Krishna's position as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. She did not know that he was Swayam Bhagavan, the original personality of Godhead, and therefore she endeavored to tie him up. Now, Swayam Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, has an innate nature. And it can also be called as Prabhav. Now, Mother Yashoda was not aware of this. She did not know that the innate nature of her son. What was the innate nature of the son? That Krishna had no beginning, no end, no inside, no outside. Krishna is all pervading. No, how can someone who possesses such quality can be tied up? It is simply impossible. Mother Yashoda simply saw Krishna as her son. So she endeavored to tie him. Now, how can such a person for whom there is no end, no exterior, no interior, no front, no rear, how can such a person be tied up? So, where would you start tying him up? Where should we? Mother Yashoda, even he wanted to tie, where should we start? So, however, Mother Yashoda succeeded in her attempt to bind Krishna. Why was that? Because of her intense love for Krishna, she believed him simply to be her son, Atmaja, an ordinary child. This intense love covered her knowledge that in fact there is nothing inside and outside of Krishna. He has no beginning or no end. This was covered. Her loving sentiments, however, predominated over Krishna's innate capacity or opulence. Now, when Mother Yashoda began to bind Krishna, a very interesting phenomenon took place. No matter what length of rope she used, when she wanted to tie the knot to her son's waist, it will always be short by width of two fingers. Now, Mother Yashoda became very astonished. It was beyond her comprehension. Still, she was determined to bind Krishna. Now, what was actually happening when Mother Yashoda was trying to bind Krishna? All of Krishna's energies had united and come to defend him. they would not let anyone bind Krishna. Now, which were the, there are so many energies of Krishna, but they are prominent. Vibhuti Shakti and Satya Sankalpa Shakti. They united and prevented him from being tied. At first, Mother Yashoda, she used a ribbon from her hair. And then it was too short. So she sent for all other cords and ropes from her house. In this way, she connected all the ropes available at home. Yet, at the final knot, was to be, when the final knot was to be tied, she found that the rope was still 2 fingers too short. One of the acharyas, they say that what was the reason why the ropes were always short? It was because Krishna was testing Mother Yashoda's determination. He wanted to see if she will give up trying to bind him up. Because Mother Yashoda's effort was not complete, Krishna's mercy was also not complete. Only upon seeing Mother Yashoda's fullest effort would Krishna extend his mercy. In other words, Krishna waits for us to give our everything to him before he gives us his special causeless mercy to us. This is why the binding rope was always short by 2 fingers. So Krishna was demonstrating that he who is not bound in the beginning nor in the end cannot be bound in the middle either. Therefore, Mother Yashoda's attempt to bind Krishna at his waist were never successful. After using all the cords and ropes from her house, she went for more from other gopis. In the meantime, several other gopis also gathered there and they were all watching this fun. And they said to Yashoda, Yashoda, release him, let him go. He is clearly not destined to be bound, to tied up. Why are you so stubborn? Now, Mother Yashoda, despite hearing this, she refused to give up. She was completely perspiring, but she did not give up. Mother Yashoda, she became even more determined and refused to give up. She said that, I will not stop until he is tied. So all the other gopis were laughing. And so was Mother Yashoda was also. Mother Yashoda was also astonished. She was also laughing. What is happening? She could not understand what was happening. But she said to herself, even if I have to stay here all day, I will tie him up. This is what she was thinking. So Mother Yashoda became tired. She became completely exhausted after a while. Her hair became loosened. All the decorating flowers were fallen. Her clothes became disarrayed. And when Krishna saw his mother's relentless determination, he showed her his mercy and agreed to be tied. Now, because of Mother Yashoda's hard labor, all the flowers and everything, she was completely tired of doing this activity. And this is what Krishna saw. And he extended his causeless mercy. So, thus ended the competition between a devotee and a Krishna. Seeing his devotee's total and unalloyed dedication, Krishna had to accept defeat. In this way, Mother Yashoda was able to tie him to an wooden grinding mortar. One may ask, can Krishna be bound up in this way? Shukadeva Goswami says, yes. One might say, why? Because of his merciful nature. Krishna can actually be tied and bound up by his devotee. Krishna's merciful nature, Kripa Shakti, prevailed and subdued all other Shaktis. Krishna's mercy potency, it subdued all other potencies. And thus Krishna got tied up. Now, through this Lila, Krishna demonstrated that he is indebted to his devotees. He can be captured by, he demonstrated that he can be captured by his devotees. Now, anyone who is truly devoted to him can bind him. The capacity to bind Krishna is in every living entity. But in order to do that, the living entity will have to develop the degree of devotion that Mother Yashoda has. Shukadeva Goswami is saying, the whole universe, including Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, are under Krishna's control. Yet he can be controlled by his devotee. This is Krishna's swabhava, his eternal nature. So when this thing was happening, Balram was not around. Balram was in a different place. Now, somebody informed Balram that, dear Balram, your brother Krishna has got tied up. Now, Balram did not hear who tied him up. He just said, Krishna got tied up. Now, Balram, he became so angry that he rushed to the place, he rushed to the house, assuming his mood as Sankarsana, and he strongly declared, who dares bind Krishna? I am Sankarsana, I am Sheshna, I can do this, I can do that. I can burn the entire universe in one breath of mine. So in this way, Balram, he was very, very angry. And he entered the house of Mother Yashoda. Now, then somebody told Balram that, Mr. Balram, it is Mother Yashoda who has tied Krishna. Now, upon hearing this, Balram's mood completely changed. He was no longer a dangerous snake, Ananta Sheshnag. He became like a timid mouse. Now, Balram saw Krishna was crying, and Krishna, seeing Balram, cried even more to invoke his mercy. Seeing Krishna crying, Balram became angry again and shouted, Do you know who is Krishna? Hey Yashoda, do you know who is Krishna? He's saying he is Narayan, he is Narasimhadev, he is Vamanadev, he is Matsya, he is everything. He is the origin of all the avatars. How dare you tie him up? Now, looking at Balram, Mother Yashoda sarcastically said, oh, I see. Krishna is the origin of all the incarnations. Wow. If that is so, then who are you, Balram? Balram replied, I am Lakshman. I am Sheshnag. I am Sankarshan. I can do this. I can do that. Now, Mother Yashoda then said, do all these incarnations have to appear only in my home? You don't have any other home in the whole world. You just have to, both of you have to come in my home. She picked up the stick and waved it threateningly at Balram, and she warned, you had better get out of from here before I beat you and bind you up and the same wooden mortar where Krishna is tied. Now, hearing this, Balram ran away. All his Sankarshan power was no longer present. Mother Yashoda was thinking, Krishna is Bhagavan? Krishna is the Supreme Lord? He hears a cat's mew and he runs to me. Lord Narasimhadev is like this? If Krishna is the Supreme Lord, why does he steal makhan? Now Mother Yashoda was thinking, this is just nonsense. Now Balram, he went to Krishna and he started scolding Krishna. Rascal, I told you many times to give up this stealing habit. Now, because you did not listen to me, you ignored my advice, now you are suffering. What can I do? if someone else could have tied you up, I could have taken care of it. But when Ma ties you up, when Mother Yashoda ties you up, what can I do? I am helpless. What can I do to stop her? So I heard that you broke the yogurt pot. Why did you do that? Even if you had broken the pot, you should just stop. But you went, continued, and you made her more angry by distributing your butter to these monkeys. Why do you have to do that, Krishna? So Balram said, seeing Balram in this way, Krishna started crying more and more and more. And seeing Krishna crying, Balram also started crying. So this continued. In the end, Balram went back to Krishna. I mean, Balram was they were just crying, and Krishna cried because he was tied up, and Balram cried because he was helpless. What to do? Poor little boys. So Sukhdev Goswami says that neither Brahma, Lord Shiva, nor anyone, even the goddess of fortune, who is always the better half of Supreme Lord, can obtain such mercy as Mother Yashoda received. Nobody, Brahma, Lord Shiva, goddess of fortune, nobody in the world has that fortune like Mother Yashoda has. Krishna possesses all possible powers. He is bound and controlled by prema. This bondage, however, being the most astonishing attribute of Krishna, is not a fault but a beautiful transcendental ornament in Krishna's personality. Now we need to understand that Krishna is self-satisfied, he is Atmaram, yet he suffers from hunger. He automatically fulfills all his desires, Aptakama, yet he is dissatisfied and desirous of prema. Now Krishna is the personification of peace and pure goodness. Still he becomes angry, Sanjata Kopa, he becomes angry. Now Krishna is the master of the goddess of fortune. Yet anxiously looking hither and thither, he steals butter like a beggar. Now, though Krishna instills fears in all through time and death, he himself flees in fear from Mother Yashoda's stick. Now, though Krishna travels at the speed of mind, he is easily caught up by the firm grip of Mother Yashoda. Though Krishna is condensed bliss, he cries in sorrow. So, though Krishna is unlimited in all pervading, he is limited by being tied up. Now, by allowing Mother Yashoda to tie him, Krishna showed, what did he show? That he can be ultimately be controlled by the love of his devotees. Krishna desired this subordination, and thus he allowed Mother Yashoda to tie him up. In this way, Krishna demonstrated that he can be totally controlled by the love and devotion of his unalloyed devotees. Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Mora putra, mora sakha, mora pranapati, ei bhava yei mora kare shuddha bhakti, apana ke bada mane amara samahin, yei bhave hai ami tahara adin. If one cherishes pure loving devotion to me, Krishna is saying, thinking of me as his son, his friend or his beloved, regarding himself as great and considering me is equal or inferior, I become subordinate to him. Now, the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, is never far from us. We may not feel so, but that is the truth proclaimed by the scriptures. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, what is Krishna says? Suradam Sarabhutanam, the most intimate well-wishing thread of all the living entities is Krishna. So, we request all the devotees that this pastimes of this Damodar Lila, we should also make a sincere effort to establish and further our relationship with him. So this Damodar Lila pastime is very, very intimate and loving pastimes. And we were in this whole month we are going to worship Krishna, being these pastimes, Mother Yashoda being tied up by Krishna. Whole month we are going to worship. So thank you very much for assembling here for this Tamad Lila session. Any questions?
Thanks. One question. The Damodar Lila is said to have occurred on the Diwali day.
Yes.
Right, Prabhu? Yeah, so let me just, I don't know if I can put this on here. Okay, I don't know if it's a little bit impersonal if you don't see me. Okay.
I can see you now.
All right. Prabhu, the Damodar Lila is said to have happened during on the Diwali day. And then we know from the Vaishnav calendar that the day after Diwali is Govardhan Puja. Right?
Yes.
So, did it happen in the spiritual world the same way? Like, I know it's not necessarily the same, but I'm just asking, was the next day the day that the Indra day of Puja supposed to happen, and then Krishna had recovered from Damodar Lila and went into this pastime? I'm not sure if that's...
So these are Damodar Lila happened at a early time, and when Krishna was very young, and Krishna chastising Indra happened at when he was 7 years old. So, okay. but this pastimes of this particular puja which was going on, Indra Puja, was going on for so many decades, so many past generations it was happening. And so Krishna knew that this is happening, but Krishna did not interfere unless he was 7 years old. Okay. Krishna, all this for first 6 years, I mean, first 6 years he was watching what was happening. When it is said that Ekada Grahe Daseshu Yashodananda Gehini, when it is said that when Mother Yashoda herself took the charge of churning the milk, churning the butter, that time she engaged the other maid servants in Indra Puja, which the next day it was Indra Yagya. So she engaged the other maid servants in the service, and told them to go outside and serve make some arrangements for the Indra Puja. So certainly when this Damodar Lila was happening, Indra Puja was the next day was Indra Puja. Then gradually when the time passed and when it was the seventh year, Krishna he interfered and he went to his father and he questioned him whether this puja is shastric or lokic. And then he stopped. So that happened in the seventh year. Damodar Lila happened in different years. But many of this Krishna's pastimes, it happened in Kartik time. So there is a lot of confusion. Okay.
All right, now that's clear. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hari Hari. Hari Hari.